Well, it's been another massive season of superstar contestants and delicious food on MasterChef Australia. And with only 11 chefs remaining, the kitchen is starting to heat up as we get closer to crowning a winner.
Yeah, so who will take out the competition and have their life changed forever? One of our favourite, MasterChef judges, Jock Zonfrillo, joins us now in the studio. Good morning, Jock.
Good morning.
First time in
finally
the
have
studio.
You here.
First time. Can't believe it.
Yeah, let's get an applause.
It's all there. Yeah, it is. I got that going, yeah. We've talked to you so many times, but never in here. It's so great to see you. Now, this season of fan and favourites, it's been one of the best. It's one of the, been one of the biggest as well. Lots of twists and turns. What's impressed you the most about this season?
We were talking about it before. I think watching the favourites become mentors,
yeah,
because it's something that they never really had to do before, and I don't think they were expecting it. Mm. All of a sudden, the fans were sort of like fangirling and going, oh, you know, I watched your season and you cooked this and you cooked that and you cooked the other. You know, can you show me this or give me some advice on that? And watching the favourites turn into favourites and start mentoring, I think, was one of the most beautiful things about this season.
I love it. It's sort of paying it forward, isn't it? It's helping the next generation come through. And there are so many more incredible dishes to come. In fact, the contestants are going head-to-head in a restaurant challenge.
Yeah.
Tell us that.
Yeah, we've got a sneaky upstairs-downstairs thing that's going on. So there's a place in the Fitzroy Inn and they've got Japanese and Italian. So there's Japanese downstairs and Italian upstairs.
Wow.
And so we split them into teams and they have to do a menu based on the cuisine. And, yeah, these are one of these service challenges where there are real customers in the restaurant. So it really puts them to the test because there's a time constraint.
Yeah.
And then obviously you've got live feedback. You've got customers who, and some of them aren't shy. They'll stick their head in the kitchen and go, I don't like this or I love that. Or it's pretty interesting.
Oh. I guess the biggest twist in it, because there's 11 people left now, that's like it's make or break. It's not generally that people get sent home because the food isn't good. They're kind of generally mistakes that they never make before, and that's the pressure that comes. So is it easy to pick a front runner or just a front runner on the day?
It's impossible. Yeah. And I think we always say that sometimes the best chef gets sent home because at the end of the day, we send the worst dish home.
Yeah.
That's the rule. And it doesn't matter if you're the best cook. If you've had the worst cook on the day, you run the risk of going home. And, you know, I think it's proof that MasterChef is such a great competition. And I think the other thing that we love about it so much is that even if you don't win, you know, if you come 10th or 12th, there is an amazing career ahead for you in food. MasterChef gives you that platform to jump off and have an amazing career in food. So it's such a great show.
Yeah, been speaking to the MasterChef contestants after they after they leave the show, and they're buzzing. They've learned so much, except Steph. Steph's got a bone to pick with you about vanilla in brownies.
Vanilla in brownies.
She doesn't think it has a place in brownies, vanilla.
Oh, well, that's why she's eliminated, I guess, isn't it?
There we go.
Don't get us started on the carbonara. Don't get us started on the carbonara.
Don't start me on carbonara, I'll tell you.
No cream, people.
I think it's funny. Sometimes it is the slightest thing that can send you home on a day. And I think everyone takes it in good spirits, you know, and I think this year more than ever you can see the end of the show when someone does get eliminated. The reaction is actually quite beautiful. You know, it's not a place of frustration or anger or whatever. They had a great time. They've met some great friends and they know they're now part of the MasterChef family moving forward.
Yeah.
And, you know, they can always pick up the phone and ring us. Some of them want to go and work in restaurants. Some of them want to, you know, go and stage in restaurants overseas. And because they're part of that network now, they've got that opportunity.
And they can appreciate that you've been through it. Because those minuscule things is the difference between good and great. Totally. And you've lived it. So
And it's the nurturing that the judges bring to the show as well. You give these contestants the wings to fly. But when you're taste testing the dishes, do you ever kind of go... like do a really bad face or do you go,
Look, I don't know how much of it they cut out. I'm fairly honest. And I think that's just the best way to be. I mean, I said at the beginning, I'm happy to be a MasterChef judge, but what you see is what you get. And if it is rubbish, I'm just gonna say it's rubbish, you know? And then on the other end of that, you'll see me give them a round of applause because, you know, I might only change one or two things. It's as good as that. And you know, they deserve a round of applause, right?
Yeah.
100%, yeah. You've been busy away from the show now as well. Obviously, you've got your memoir, which is fantastic. I've read it a lot. Yeah, Last Shot at Claude. It explores some of your highs and lows of your life. For people who haven't read it yet, can you tell us what inspired the book?
Look, I think everyone sees Jock Zonfrillo on MasterChef, three-piece suit, and, you know, a successful guy on the telly. And all too often, there's little parts of your life that get sort of picked out and put in a newspaper, and some of them are not moments that I'm particularly proud of in my life. And so, you know, I've got a 21-year-old, a 16-year-old, a 4-year-old, and a 1.5-year-old, right? And
you've lived so much life.
I've had a full life, and there is a lot that is in that book, more that I'm not proud of than I am. Mm. And I've never lied to my kids about, you know, about the trials and tribulations that I've had, and I hope to be able to help them through, you know, the same situation should they arise for them. But I want them to see, and other people to see, who might be struggling, whether it's obsession or addiction like I did, that there is a path out. There is a way that you can come to the other side of that and still be successful, you know? And so whether it's drug addiction or whether it's obsessive-compulsive behaviours, you know, for me it was important just to get it, my truth, my story, you know, so it's there and it's on record. And so, and I don't want to, I've never wanted to hide it or shy away from it either. So it felt like the right time, given that there was, you know, MasterChef Jock and everyone was like, oh, there's TV guys. Like, yeah, there's a whole other half.
But it's a story of redemption, which I love. That's what I love about it.
Yeah, and I think, you know, it was a path for me, you know, going from drug addiction to a successful television career is not the normal path of a drug addict post-addiction. So I'm, you know, one in a million, I guess. Mm. But for me, I've found a place of happiness now, which I never thought I would have, to be honest with you. I mean, if you wind back pre-2000s when I was a drug addict, you just can't see the way out, you know? So it takes some big changes in your life and a lot of bravery and meeting the right people and having the right help along the way to guide you through some of those big changes in your life.
And people are getting that opportunity. People are getting that opportunity because you're touring your book now as well. So it's not just something that people can read. They actually come and meet you and they can talk to you about it.
Yeah, last night we did a book signing at Buck Mulligan's, and it's a whiskey bar in Northcote. And there was a young lad that was 2 months clean off of heroin, and he was there with his dad. They were both reading the book at the same time. He was sort of saying, it's amazing to read. He was in hospitality as well. He's a waiter. And he was just saying, it's amazing to read the book and you know, be able to relate to it. Like, I'm going through some of these struggles, and the way you describe it and talk about how you rationalize getting out of that situation, I'm able to relate to it. It's really helpful. Mm. Whereas his dad was reading the book and saying, I've found a new way to understand my son's problem and to help him through the other side of it. And so stuff like that for me is, you know, it's amazing.
Yeah. Jock is touring the country with his memoir, Last Shot, is a cracker. It's available right now. For more info and to get your tickets, you can head over to Jock's Instagram or Facebook page. And don't forget, MasterChef Australia tonight, 7:30, right here on 10. Don't be a stranger. Now that you've been in here, come and visit us anytime.
I'm just going to pop in. Yeah. I'll just come on in.
Bring You're food. Always welcome. Yeah. Good on you.
Thanks, Jock.
Hey, if you're liking what we're putting down, if you're liking the merchandise, subscribe here.
And to see more videos in this series, go here.